This is what the Bible said. All these things speak Jesus unto the multitude in parables. And without a parable speak he not unto them. Verse 35. That it might be fulfilled which was spoken by the prophet, saying, I will open my mouth in parables. I will utter things which have been kept secret from the foundation of the world. Everybody shout, secret from the foundation of the world.
Secret from the foundation of the world.
In Matthew chapter 25, verse 34, this is what the Bible said. Matthew 25, 34. Then shall the king say unto them on his right hand. Everybody shout, on his right hand.
On his right hand.
Come, ye blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. Praise God. Hallelujah. May the Lord will bless the reading of His word. And through the help of the Holy Spirit, I will preach to you this afternoon. Praise God. Hallelujah. Of continuation of the preaching about the kingdom of heaven. You may now take your seats and the Lord will bless us all. Last Sunday, who can still remember the message last Sunday? Praise God. The willing garment. Praise God. It's about the parable of the kingdom of heaven. But before anything else, praise God. Hallelujah. After the service, as we have already discussed, I'm going to meet all the Unit 1 and Unit 2. Praise God. Hallelujah. This Sunday after the service. Praise God. And I don't know where should be our place because after the service, there will be some noises here. Praise God. So maybe I will ask the other group to just suspend a little minutes and give to Unit 1 and Unit 2. Next Sunday, Unit 3 and Unit 4, praise God, I'm going to meet you also. Praise God, hallelujah. And I asked your prayer, praise God. I will make every one of you to be a prayer warrior this week for me. To continue my story, the story of the Lord about the kingdom of heaven. Hallelujah. Now, in this Holy Communion, I'm going to prepare, praise God, the Lord will prepare your heart through the preaching of His words, praise God. So our guests and visitors, I hope that you will not feel boring, praise God, because at this time, all I need to do is to read the scripture and put some emphasis on those lines before we take the Holy Communion. Everybody shall amen.
Amen.
In Matthew chapter 13, verse 24 down to 30, this is what the Bible said. Another parable. So aside from the wedding garment that I mentioned to you last Sunday, this is the good thing when we can continue preaching, praise God, because I can continue the story. Mm-hmm. And we will continue until the end of July. Hallelujah. Everybody say amen.
Amen.
There's another parable. Put he forth unto them saying, the kingdom of heaven is likened unto a man. We sow good seed in his field. Now remember what Jesus, hallelujah, had told his disciples concerning the kingdom of heaven. That it's like a man who threw away seeds into the field. Verse 25. This is what the scripture said. But while men sleep, his enemy came. So when the men of God will sleep, the enemy grab the opportunity.
Yes.
So men, don't sleep. Now, the scripture is not about talking about the gender of male and female. Talks about everybody, praise God, who worked in the kingdom of God as a servant of His gospel. They were laborers in the kingdom. But laborers should have a day off. Laborers should have a time to sleep. What will you do, praise God, if you sign a contract and your employer will not allow you to sleep? Now, it's a big problem.
Yeah.
We will go to the labor department and file a case.
Yeah.
Why my employer did not allow me to sleep? Some of you sleep like 11, 12, or 1 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah.
And you wake up so early.
Yeah.
That is why when you walk on the market, you are so rogue, praise God. Everybody shall praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
So in this parable, the laborers of the kingdom, of course, they have a day off, they sleep. And the moment that they sleep, his enemy came. and sowed tares among the wheat, and went his way. Now the word sleep here is also a spiritual picture that when the laborers of the kingdom will become weak, praise God, the enemy will grab the opportunity, praise God, to sow also his own seeds, the seeds of tares. Everybody say amen.
Amen.
That is why Jesus said, we must be prayerful and we must be watchful in our lives. Why? The moment na manghina ka, the moment that you become weak in your faith, the enemy will grab that opportunity to sow doubts, to sow seeds or thoughts, praise God, of discouragement into your life. Now this is about the kingdom of heaven.
Amen.
Verse 26, look at the scripture. I want you to read on the screen. But when the blade was sprung up and brought forth fruit, then appeared the tares also. So when the wind was growing, the blade also already appeared. Praise God. The tares also appeared.
Yeah.
And the laborers were so shocked why there were tares.
Yeah.
Praise God. We only saw the pure wheat seeds. Verse 27. It is sometimes a question. Pastor, di ba bautisado na tayong lahat? Bakit may pasaway pa rin?
This is the kingdom of heaven.
Everybody shout,
praise the Lord.
So the servants of the householder came and said unto him, Sir, did not thou sow good seed in thy field? From whence then hath it tears? Saan po nang galing? Verse 28. Here we go. He said unto them, an enemy hath done this. So, this is what I'm going to tell you. In the family, in a relationship, if there are some commotion and conflicts, pag may away sa kapwa mo, trabahante sa bahay niya mo, the enemy has done that.
Amen.
I will rest you assured. It is not God. It is not God thing. But if there are conflicts, if there are, praise God, you know, quarreling, if there are misunderstanding in any kind of relationship, whether church, family, or job, the enemy has done that. So do not blame people. Ikaw kasi. Ikaw. No. The enemy has done that. Everybody shall praise the Lord. So please, don't get angry to your husband. And say, ikaw kasi. Ikaw. Tingnan mo yung mukha mo. Ikaw. No. Don't blame your husband. Don't blame people. Don't blame your leader. Don't blame anybody because the enemy has done that. In the kingdom of heaven, praise God, the Spirit of God is very powerful. That is why he said we need to pray, we need to be watchful. Because the moment we sleep, the moment, praise God, that we lose our control, the enemy will grab the opportunity. Everybody say,
praise the Lord.
An enemy hath done this. The servant said unto him, wilt thou then that we go and gather them up? Will you allow us to go there and, you know, take away those plants that are not, praise God, necessary in our field? But he said, praise God, in verse 29. Verse 29 says, he said in verse 29, no. The word nay is very old English. No. Lest while ye gather up the tares, ye root up also the wheat with them. So, see for example, in this kingdom of God, in this church, me and Pastor Librado are servants. Now, if we can see in the church, somebody is making trouble, we cannot just tell this sister, this is the last time that I can see your face. No life fellowship. Don't come back here. You are a troublemaker. In the kingdom of God, you cannot do that. The household, the owner said, no, don't do that. Because if I will tell him, I will take her away out of this group, praise God, because this woman is a troublemaker. What if she have 5 relatives? What if she have 10 kumari?
Mari, pinalis ko ni Pastor Plaza. Samahan ka namin, Mari. Huwag kang bumalik doon. That is why Jesus said, no, you cannot do that. You cannot take out the ears out of the group of the weak. So kahit masaway ka ngayon, never po namin gagawin na parang simple. Kahit may magsuggest sa amin, if anybody will suggest us, please, Pastor Asa, we will find petition that this woman will not come to New Life. We cannot do that.
Yeah.
So, Pastor, may sakit sa church pag ganun, Pastor. Kung hindi natin palisin, Jesus said, no, you cannot, God, praise God, you cannot root out that. Verse 30, here we go. So, what would be the solution? Jesus said, let both grow together. Wala po dito sa New Life. Yung mga may kabit, wala po yan sa New Life.
Yeah.
Wala kami mga bisita.
Yes.
I can assure you, dito sa New Life, wala pong member dito na nangangabit.
Yes.
Nangangalun niya, wala po.
Yes.
Pero hindi ko po alam kung sino, may sikrino. Jesus said, and in the time of the harvest, I will say to the reapers, gather ye together first, unahin ang mga tears, mga kapatid. Bind them in bundles to burn them, but gather the wheat into my barn. Now remember, this is a parable. Verse 31. Hallelujah. Verse 34, Sudan. Let's jump to verse 34. Here we go. All these things speak Jesus unto the multitude in parables. But without a parable, speak He not unto them. When Jesus spoke to the people, to the listeners in the public, He always used parables. Because it was written, according to verse 35, hallelujah, verse 35, that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken by the prophet, saying, I will open my mouth in parables. I will utter things which have been kept secret from the foundation of the world. So there is a secret in the foundation of the world that many generations have no idea what is that secret in the world. Everybody say amen.
Amen.
Verse 36. Here we go. Then Jesus sent the multitude away and went into the house. And his disciples came unto him, saying, declare unto us the parable of the tares of the field. In other words, listen to me. Even his disciples did not understand the parable.
Amen.
Even his disciples did not understand what Jesus was talking about concerning the kingdom of heaven. So when Jesus arrived into their house or in their boarding house or apartment, the disciples asked him, can you please explain to us the parable concerning the tares and the wheat? 37. Listen to this. Because Jesus is the one who explained. Hallelujah. He answered and said unto them, he that soweth the good seed is who?
The Son of Man.
The sower of the good seed is the Son of Man. Question, who is the Son of Man?
Jesus
Christ is the Son of Man. So, that it's very obvious that the reason why you arrived here, the reason why your heart really loved the gospel, because there is someone, the Christ, the Messiah, Jesus Christ, sows seeds in your heart. It was not Pastor Plaza who sowed the seeds. It was not a man who sowed the seeds. But it was Christ Jesus who put faith, hallelujah, the words of the gospel into your heart that you believe and now you walk therein. Shall we bow our heads to Jesus? Jesus' explanation. The one who sowed the seed is the Son of Man. But that is the beginning of his explanation. In verse 38, here we go. The Bible said, the field is the world. So simple. The field is the world. The world represents here all kind of people, all types of heart. Okay? The good seed are what?
Children.
The children of the kingdom. So it is Jesus who sowed the seed into the field. The field is the world. We are living in the world right now. And if you claim that you are a Christian, Jesus is the one who sowed that seed. And he put you inside this church. Everybody shout amen.
Amen.
So wherever you go around the world, praise God, because you are a Christian, you're a child of God, it is Jesus who put you in that particular place.
Amen.
So the good seed are the children of the kingdom. But the tares are the children of the wicked one. This is the most dangerous thing. Because if you look at, you can Google it. Tares versus wheat. They look like the same. Their color is the same. You cannot sometimes guess which is tares or which is a wheat. Because they are just almost the same. What my point is this. The children of the kingdom and the children of the wicked one can almost identically be the same. Look to your left. Look to your right. Kamayan mo siya, sabihin mo sa kanya, you're a child of God. We are the children of the kingdom. Pero tika-tika, pastor. Hindi ako sure. You should make it sure that you are part of the children of the kingdom. Because inside the field, inside in this world, there are also children of the wicked one. Verse 39, Jesus did not stop, hallelujah, to explain the parable. The enemy that sold them is the devil. Nobody loves the devil.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Nobody likes the devil.
Yeah.
Everybody shall amen.
Amen.
Even those people who look like a devil, they don't like the devil.
Praise God.
The enemy that sold them is the devil. What do you mean by the harvest? The harvest is the end of the world. Now, is the parable clear unto you?
Yes.
But Jesus continues to explain. He said, the harvest is the end of the world. The reapers are the angels. So when the trumpet will sound, when the rapture will take place, it's all the angels who have the job to gather all the children of the kingdom from the four corners of the earth and to meet the Lord in the air. It is the angel of God. Now remember the parable, uunahin pagligpit ng anghel ng mga anak ng kasamaan. Verse 40, here we go. As therefore the tares are gathered are burned in the fire, so shall be, so shall it be in the end of the world. Now if you don't believe hell, if you don't believe, praise God, the punishment of the wicked, here is the scripture. That Jesus said, in this parable of the kingdom, that the harvest is the end of the world, and those tares that being bind together shall be burned in the fire. And Jesus said, so shall it be in the end of the world. There must be a big bonfire of people who are wicked.
Yes.
Jesus would not lie. Verse 41, here we go. The Son of Man shall send forth his angels, and they shall gather out of his kingdom all things that offend, and them which do. There are two categories here. Number one, Sister Annalyn, is this. God will send his angels to take out, to gather out, not in, to gather out of His kingdom all things that offend. Ano yung sabihin ng pastor? Tagalogin mo nga? Sige, kahit ako'y Bisaya. Ang lahat ng gumagawa ng kapitisuran sa loob ng grupo, sa iglesia, sa unit, tatanggalin ng Panginoon. Bisaya, ang tanang mga mantito, ang hinundan ngayon ang pando. Lawang siya. English? English? Here in the screen. The Psalm when Jesus Christ will send His angels and He will gather out His kingdom. All things that offend. So this is now our job today. You need to examine yourself. Do not examine the lives of others. What kind of pakialamina sa buhay na iba? You need to examine yourself. Pastor Plaza, during service, during preaching, if you sleep, that's an offense to God. During your day off, you go to the beach. Instead to come to the church, you are an offense. Pinapuspos mo, pati ng tago pa kami lahat, mga kapatid. Hello, everybody. Are you okay? I am a preacher, I am a servant of the living God. I cannot withhold what is truth. And I am explaining to you what Jesus said concerning the parable of the kingdom. All things that offend. If your behavior can offend somebody, please change your behavior. If your words can offend somebody, change your words. But if your face can offend somebody, don't change your face. Celebration, papalitan mo yung mukha. Don't change your face. But the Word of God can change our lives. Everybody say, praise the Lord. So is it clear for us? Anything that offends, anything that goes against the will of God, angels will take care of it. And what else? Category 2. And then, go back to that verse, 41. And then, that do iniquity. Atas kasis. And then, the first one is things. It does not refer to people. Things. Yung gamit ko ba? iPhone 14 ka, tapos yung kasama mo, hindi mo binayaran kahit $100 lang. Things that can offend! Sis, may bago akong iPhone. iPhone 18. Tapos yung sinabihan niya, may kulang pa siya 200. I just wake you up, but you know what I mean. In the first category, it talks about things that offend. But in the number two, people, them which do iniquity. What do you mean by iniquity? You practice sin in your life privately that nobody knows except God. Hindi naman ako nakikita ni Pastor kahit dalawa po ipin ko. Hey, God can see you. Iniquity means doing against the will of God. It is habit, or it is your conversation, should I say, a daily lifestyle practicing sin. Amen. Hello?
Amen.
So Jesus said, angels will take care of that at the end of the days. And what will the angel do? Verse 42. Open your eyes wide. And the angels will what?
Cast
them, people, them, into a furnace of fire. There shall be wailing and gnashing of teeth, crying without end.
Yes.
I hope that we understand what is eternity. Eternity means a million years is just a beginning.
Yes.
Eternity is very long, long, long. There's no ending of eternity. The children of the wicked one will be thrown into or cast into the lake of fire. Hallelujah. Last verse. Then shall the righteous shall shine forth as the sun in the kingdom of their Father. And the Holy Spirit said, who have ears to hear? Let him hear. Kung may nakabara sa iyong tinga, tanggalin mo yung nakabara. Then ang sabi ng Panginoon, those who have ears, let them listen, let them hear what Jesus said, because this is very important concerning the kingdom of heaven. So what's the story in Matthew 25:31-46? I will read to you another explanation of the Bible. When the Son of Man shall come in His glory, here we go, when Jesus will set, being God over all, in the end of times, we don't know when, but it will come, and all the holy angels with Him, then shall He sit upon the throne of His glory. Jesus will sit on His kingly throne in heaven. And you know what happened in verse 32? All the people from Adam to the last man will be born. Hallelujah, all the people of the nations. And before Him shall be gathered all nations. And He shall separate what? He shall separate them one from another. As a shepherd divided his sheep from the goats.
Yes.
In the last, hallelujah, I want you to understand this. What is the kingdom of heaven? What will happen, Pastor Plaza, at the end of time? God will separate only two divisions. One of His right, one of His left.
Yes.
The sheep and the goats. Dito malalaman, mga kapatid, kung sino ang tupa at sino yung kambing. Yung mga kambing na bahihi, mga kapatid, reklamo. At yung tupa, mga kapatid, what I'm talking, Sister Selby, is, hallelujah, I'm talking about a shepherd that will divide the sheep and the goat. The goat always complain. The goat is always noisy. The sheep is just humble now for God. He shall set the sheep on His right hand. Everybody shout, right hand.
Right hand.
But the goats where?
Left.
On the left. It doesn't mean that on your left right now is the goat. And on your right is the sheep. No, it does not mean like that. Everybody shout, praise God. Verse 34. Hallelujah. Okay, read it with me. Read it, go. Then shall the king say unto them on his right hand, come, ye blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. Now remember, in Matthew 13, there was a secret from the foundation of the world. Hallelujah. And the secret is that all of us who believe in Jesus, all of us, praise God, who receive Him, shall inherit this, what the Bible said, prepared for you from the foundation of the world. That is the secret. The secret was eternal life. Everybody shall amen. Verse 35. Let's read it as fast as we can. For I was hungry and He gave me meat. I was thirsty and He gave me drink. I was a stranger and He took me in. 36. Naked, He clothed me. I was sick, He visited me. I was in prison, He came unto me. Verse 37. These people answered. Then shall the righteous answer Him, saying, Lord, when saw we thee a hungry or feed thee? Kailan ka namin nakita na ikaw na gutom at pinakain namin ngayon? Or thirsty and give thee drink? 38. Here we go. When saw thee with thee a stranger and took thee in, or naked and clothed thee? What was Jesus' answer in verse 39? Or when we saw the sick or in prison and came after thee? Verse 40 is Jesus' answer. And the king shall answer and say unto them, verily I say unto you, inasmuch as ye have done it unto one of the least of my brethren, ye have done it unto me. Very simple. I will explain it to you. Who was on the right side? The sheep, the righteous.
The sheep.
And Jesus said, okay, those who are on the right side, please come in, inherit my kingdom, enjoy your life forever. On the right side, the righteous said, why, Lord? Grabe, tinanong pa si Lord, why? Because when I was hungry, you feed me. When I was thirsty, you give me drink. When I was naked, binilang ako ng Giordano. You clothed me. When I was in prison, you visited me. When I was sick, you visited me. Everybody say amen. Oh, because what you have, Jesus said, what you have done to the least of your brethren. Ano, ano, ano? Kasi minsan, pag tayo nagbibigay, binibigyan natin yung palabigay sa atin.
Yes.
Diba?
Yes.
Totoo yan, mga kapatid.
Yes.
That's true. Kung sino natin palaging dinadala sa makto, yung nagdadala din sa atin sa KFC. Puro yun, pero yung mga hindi nag-invite sa atin, hindi natin in-invite. That's natural. Yes. That's natural. But in the kingdom of heaven, it should be the opposite. Because Jesus said, what you have done to the least. What do you mean you have done to the least? Yung wala-wala. Yung nakakaawa. Binubuksa mo, binababa, walang papasali, binibigay ng pera. Tapos sabihin mo lang, God bless you, sister, I'm praying for you. Sis, hindi pa ako nakakain. Naiwan yung wallet ko. Pinalis ako ni amo. Sige, sis, God bless you, I'm praying for you. Samantalang ang wallet mo, mga kapatid, puputok na sa kadadami. Praise God, ng blessing. What you have done to the least, you have done it unto Jesus. What you have done to your neighbors who are poor, you have done it to Jesus.
Yes.
Don't be shy to visit prisons. Huwag kayong mahiyak, bumisita ng mga kulungan. Eh, pastor, baka nga mapicturan pa ako. Don't be shy to visit prisons, especially some of your friends, relatives who are in prison, especially during the Tokhan time, praise God, the drug war. There are people who are still in the prison house because of some, you know, praise God, cases that was being filed against them. Visit them. Because Jesus said, even to those prisons, even to these criminals, if you visit them, Jesus said, ask if you are visiting me. If somebody is sick, praise God, you visit her. Pag may nagkasakit, huwag mo sabihin, buti na sa'yo, sister, kasi itas na puno mo. Sakit pa yung tao, tapos ganunin mo ba? When somebody is sick, sister, that's present. Hallelujah. When somebody is sick, visit her, encourage her. Hallelujah. Don't say that, you are sick because you are not faithful. You are sick because you are young. Don't let them hear that kind of words. It doesn't help them. It cannot heal them. But even if you visit, praise God to those people who are, you know, mourning because someone died in the family, just visit her. Show yourself them. Speaking, nothing. Because your presence is enough for them. Put our hands to the Lord one more time. So from this day, if you want to be in the right side, I said, if you want to be in the right side at the end of the kingdom, do to the least of our brethren.
Amen.
Help them. Literal help.
Yes.
It's not a figurative help. I see. Don't worry, I already helped you. In my mind, I really helped you. No. Do that. Hallelujah. Verse 41. Then shall he say also unto them on the left. Yung gusto sa left, makinig kayo. And I will not encourage you to go to the left. Then shall he say unto them on the left hand, depart from me, ye cursed, into everlasting fire. There is an everlasting fire.
Yes.
Prepared for the devil and his angels. So hell and the lake of fire, yung infierno, it is a place, Hades,
Di bakit ka sasama?
That is an exclusive place for the devil and his angels. Why you want to follow the devil? I don't want to follow the devil, Pastor Plaza. But your behavior is like devilish.
Yes.
Worldly. Carnal. There is an everlasting fire. Verse 42. Here we go. For I was hungry, Jesus said. He repeat again. I was hungry, you gave me no meat. I was thirsty, and you gave me no drink. Next. Verse 43. I was a stranger, he took me not in. Naked, he clothed me not. Sick, and in prison, he visited me not. Hallelujah. Verse 44. Then shall they also answer him, saying, Lord, when? So we be at hungry. Kaya nga binakita ka, Panginoon, na nagutom ka. Kaya kasi nagutom ka naman. Kung nakita ka lang namin, sigurado. You sinuya pa, Panginoon. Dahil mo sila. A pierced, stranger, naked, sick, in prison, and did not minister unto me. You did not minister unto me. Verse 46, Jesus answered, hallelujah. Is that the last verse? 46. 45, then shall he answer them, saying, verily I say unto you, inasmuch as ye did it not to one of the least of these, ye did it not to me. When someone will help you, especially tourists, Filipino tourists, or anybody, where's the direction for one side? Don't tell them going to Kennedy. At least by helping in direction, you can help. You need it for Jesus. They are strangers. Yeah. They don't know where to go.
Yeah.
Yeah. Praise God. Verse 46. Here we go. And this shall go away. Into what? Everlasting punishment. But the righteous where? It's your choice. I said, it's your choice. Colossians 1, 25, praise God, to 27, or 28. Whereof I am made a minister according to the dispensation of God, Paul wrote, which is given to me for you to fulfill the word of God. Next verse, that's the ministry of Apostle Paul. He said, I am here to fulfill the ministry of the word of God. Even the mystery which had been hid from ages, from generations, by now is made manifest to his saints. Look at this verse. What was secret in Matthew 13 from the foundation of the world, what was from the foundation of the world that we know, Paul said that this mystery had been hid, naitago, from ages and from generations, but is now made manifest. There is now a revelation of the secret of the ages, and it was being revealed to where?
Saints.
Sa mga panalang po, sa mga palaging nag-church, sa mga palaging nag-pray, this revelation, Madagasi sisters, has been revealed to those people who always pray, to those people who always worship, to those people, hallelujah, who dedicate their life to God. Verse 27, to whom God would make known what is the riches of the glory of this mystery among the Gentiles, which is, what is the mystery? That Christ in you, the hope of glory. Jesus is in your heart. He is the hope of that glory. Jesus is coming soon. Without Christ in your heart, you're nothing. Hallelujah. It's the Lord Himself in Jesus. He is the hope of His glory. Another letter from Apostle Paul in Ephesians chapter 3, verse 1 to 6. This is what the Bible said. For this cause, I, Paul, the prisoner of Jesus Christ, for you Gentiles. Now, we are Gentiles. We are not Jewish in blood. Okay? I make a point here. This letter has been written to the Ephesian believers. And this is what Paul said. I am a prisoner of Jesus Christ for you Gentiles. Paul was taken to prison by preaching the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ to the Gentiles. But he said, I am a prisoner of Jesus Christ because of you Gentiles. Tell yourself, I'm a Gentile. We are Gentile. But when the gospel arrived and we believe and we respond to the call of God,
hallelujah,
we become the redeemed.
Yes.
Tayo yung darilin mga tinubos ni Jesus. Verse 2. Look at the screen. If you have Bible, follow me. If ye have heard of the dispensation of the grace of God, which is given me to you, Lord. Verse 3. How that by what? Revelation. Because it was a secret. Now it's been revealed, manifested. How that by revelation he made known unto me the mystery as I wrote upon in few words. Next verse. This is what Jesus had posed. Whereby will ye read, ye may understand my knowledge in the mystery of Christ. Now that we are reading his words, it's easy now to understand. But before Paul, it was not easy to understand. Why? It was not yet revealed. Next verse. Verse 5. Which in other ages, during the time of Noah, during the time of David, during the time of Isaiah, this mystery has been hidden. Which in other ages was not made known unto the sons of men, as it is now revealed unto his holy apostles and prophets by the Spirit. Next verse, last verse. Ano po yung nireveal? That the Gentiles should be fellow heirs and of the same body and partakers of his promise in Christ by the gospel. That even though we are Gentiles, there is a secret. The secret is now no more a secret. That we Gentiles are partakers also of the life eternal, of the glory that is to come. Clap your hands unto the Lord. Last verse. Everybody shout, thank you, Pastor Blasa.
Thank you.
Kasi last na po. 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 5. This revelation, your life and my life, has been kept by the power of God through faith unto salvation, ready to be revealed in the last time. Each and every one of us has been kept by the power of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We are kept by the power of God. And all of us here, we are not billionaires. We are not like, praise God, rich people. We are not famous in Hollywood. No one ever knows our name. Yes. Try to go to Jim Satchoy. Praise God. If these rich people will, you know, entertain you. Mm-hmm. Because they don't know us. Yeah. Even if you go to Malacanang Palace, they don't know our name. But what happened, Pastor Blasa? When Jesus will come, all of us will be revealed to the whole world. The whole world can see, oh, that's the OFW in Hong Kong in 2024. Kasama ko siya sa market eh. Nakita ko yan sa market eh. I saw him in the market. I saw her in the market. Alam ko may aso yan, hinihila-hila. Siya yan. Siya talaga yan. God will reveal you to the whole world in these last days. But if you are the children of the wicked one, susunukin, itatapon ka agad. But the righteous, but those people, praise God, who choose Jesus Christ,
yes,
you will be revealed in the last days. And all the eyes of the people of the world can see. From hate, mula sa impyerno, makita nila sa kanilang mga mata. Yan talaga, kumari ko yan eh. Hala, nandun na siya sa langit. Tapos yung nandun sa langit, hi, Wally, nandito na ako. Hindi na kasi naniwala sa akin eh.
Yes!
During the long no eh, pamantay-pantay ka lang. Patong hits to hits, pa-iluminom dyan.
Amen.
Sabi na, oo, yun. Tagal yung night lang sila. Kasi nagbisita ako doon. Kaya mga bisita, sumama ka na sa right side. That's why it's the praise of the Lord. Jesus is our salvation. It's not this group. New Life Fellowship is just a denomination, cannot save you.
Yes.
But this denomination preaches that there's only one God. His name is Jesus. I bring you to the last story before we will do this Holy Communion. You need to look at the message of the cross. When Jesus died on the cross, There were three crosses on the cross. Tatlo po.
Yes.
Jesus was in the middle. On the right side is a criminal. On the left side is also a criminal.
Yeah.
Look, the cross of Jesus was the dividing line between the right and the left.
Yes.
And the left side criminal said, "If you are truly the Son of God, if you are truly the Messiah, save yourself and also save us."
Yes.
And the criminal on the right side said, "Pray. Huwag ka masalitan na pray. We are condemned because we are all criminals.
Yes.
But this man have no fault. He have no sin." And then after talking to the left side criminal, the right side criminal said, "Lord, when you come into your kingdom, remember me."
Yes.
And what did Jesus reply before he came? Praise God, he spread out. Jesus said, today, not tomorrow, but today,
yes,
you will be with me in paradise.
Yes.
Jesus don't care if you are a sinner or not.
Yes.
What he cares is, are you willing to worship him?
Yes.
Are you willing to submit to the lordship of Jesus Christ? It doesn't matter what you have done yesterday. It doesn't matter how dark is your life. It doesn't matter kung kaano kadami sa kasalanan mo kay ilang tuminatabayan. What God is looking for is, Lord, remember me. Remember me. He did not even say, "Forgive me, Lord, I'm a criminal." No. He just asked the Lord. Lord, he addressed Jesus. Lord, remember me when you come into your kingdom. And Jesus replied, "Today, I tell you verily, today, you will be with me in paradise." Listen to this. The right side criminal accepted the Lord and he has eternal life.
Yes.
The left side criminal rejected the Lord and he perished. The question this afternoon, on which side are you?
Hallelujah.
On which side you are right now? Put down your pride.
Amen.
Forget yourself. Even if you are a professional one, even if you have lots of money in the bank and properties, forget it. Because the things of this world, we cannot bring it there. Those are temporal. But the things that Jesus shares to us are eternal. And what He speaks is the Spirit of life. Kaya this afternoon, hallelujah, I want you to realize this one thing. Holy Communion is very powerful. Holy Communion is not just a church sacrament that you take the Eucharist in the morning and then you go to the sabungan in the afternoon. It doesn't work like that.
Yeah.
When you take Holy Communion, praise God, hallelujah, it means that, hallelujah, you remember the pain, the agony, the sacrifice of the Messiah just to pay all our sin on the cross. And Jesus said, the moment you take the Holy Communion, you are looking forward for the soon coming of Jesus. The one who died will come back. And it calls for a dedication. It calls for a commitment. You need to discern the body of Christ. What do you mean by discern the body of Christ, Sister Daisy? It means that you love everybody. Because everyone is a part of the body.
Yes.
No one in his right mind will get a hammer, hallelujah, and pupukais this one. What's the English of pupukais? His right man to get a knife and try to cut his skin. Why? Even if you cut a little, the whole body will suffer.
Yeah.
What do you mean by that? We are one body in Christ. We need to love each other. We need to practice and to live in a spirit of unity. What do you mean by that? I will not chismis somebody. Hindi ako mag-maritisize, ha? Mga kapatid, ano ka gabi ko, pastor? Huwag ka na mag-maritis. Mag-Kristiyano ka na lang. Kung ano yung sarili. In the Philippines, Sister Sylvie, we have one saying, taas mo, kahit kanino, ako ay
Christian.
Praise God, nations will gather them. And the king will separate one from another. On the right, okay, go on the left. On the right, on the left. Right, go into the kingdom. Left, go to the fire. That's simple as that. So now that we are in this, hallelujah, time waiting for the coming of the Lord, the gospel said, believe on the Lord.
Amen.
And you shall be saved. Believing is receiving Him. Repent of your sins. Be baptized in the name of Jesus. Be filled with the Holy Spirit. Change your lifestyle in the power of the Lord. Salvation belongs to God. It does not belong to anybody. So the Holy Communion in 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 23. 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 23 is our Holy Communion today. Sa aming mga bisita, just observe and be in prayer. But to those who are already baptized in the name of the Lord, I encourage you to join. But you need to examine yourselves, because that's the rule. You need to examine yourself. We should do what is right before God. But if, you know, we are human, sometimes we commit mistakes, we can ask the forgiveness of the Lord.
Yes.
If someone here right now, you are angry to her, you have misunderstanding, I advise you, before you take the Holy Communion, come to that woman and be at peace with yourself. Hindi ka pwede mag-Holy Communion na may galit na puso. Kanan? It will bring death and curse. You cannot take a Holy Communion if you are angry to somebody.
Yes.
If you have an indifferent spirit, what we need to do is to humble ourselves and receive our brothers and sisters as we are one in the kingdom of God. Jesus Christ already forgiven them. Who are you not to forgive? If God forgives this woman or man. So this afternoon, that's the message of the kingdom of God. The enemy also saw the seeds of the wicked, but the angel also, praise God, saw, hallelujah, the servants of the Lord saw also, the Son of Man saw the seeds of the children of the kingdom. Pastor Plaza, I'm curious, Pastor Plaza. I'm serious. How to go to the right side? I want to go to the right side. At all costs, Pastor Plaza, I will go to the right side. No way that I will go to the left side, because I know the ending of the left side. But I want to go to the right side. If you want to go to the right side, it is simple. Believe the Lord, serve the Lord, make everything right.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And ask the Lord, Lord, be the Lord of my life. Ikaw na Panginoon ang hahawak sa madumila sa aking buhay. Linago masunod, ikaw na. Ang laman, gusto ko Panginoon, mga bisyo, mga kalayawan, lahat, Panginoon, pero ikaw na masunod, Panginoon. It is painful. But if you will just realize and understand that He paid it all on the cross,
hallelujah,
then it's worth it, mga kapatid, na magpakumbaba tayo. Salitan na.
Yes! Yes!
Whoever is the one assigned, praise God, to take this, to distribute this, now I call you. Can we distribute lahat ng mga hostia, lahat ng wine, mga kapatid? Can we distribute it? We will put all these things in order. And we will eat at the same time. We will drink at the same time, as the scripture said. Kasi ang sabi ng Bible, dapat mag-antayan. Hindi po pwede, mga kapatid, na magpila. Na yung iba naka-uwi na sa boarding house, yung iba hindi pa nakakain, mga kapatid. If you are baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus, please join. Guests and visitors, I advise you just observe. This is the apostolic way to celebrate the communion. Everybody shall praise the Lord. And while you are holding it, while you are holding it, praise God, I ask you to look back what Jesus had done on the cross of Calvary. Did you hear me?
Habang hinahawakan nyo ito, sana ang ating imagination, ang ating isip, ay wala, wag muna sa bahay ni amo, wag muna sa marami pang trabahuhin doon mga kapatid mamaya. Sana mga kapatid, praise God, sana you will look back to the cross of Calvary. Jesus died for us. If you are baptized in the name of Jesus, just get one. Sa aming mga bisita, just observe at this time. You can come back and join again the next time, praise God, hallelujah. This is very important because we are going to recognize the Lordship of the Lord Jesus Christ and His agony on the cross and His sacrifice on the cross. He wants everybody to be saved, for Jesus loves us so much. He wants. Hallelujah. I was a sinner. Our men here, we were all sinners. But Christ had redeemed us, the power of His blood. The kingdom of heaven, this parable is very unique. Habang hinahawakan mo ang ustiya sa kanang kamay, if you have it, pwede na kayo makatayo, mga kapatid. You can stand if you are holding already the bread and the wine. And I'm waiting for the signal if everybody is already ready. And we will eat this together according to the scripture. Sundin natin ang salita ng Diyos, mga kapatid, kasi yun ang pinaka-safe at pinaka-maganda. Humingi tayo ng tawad sa Panginoon sa lahat ng ating mga lapses. Humingi tayo, mga kapatid, magpakumbaba tayo sa Panginoon. Lahat ng mga kahipokritohan ng ating pag-augali ay dapat na natin itanggal at isuko sa Panginoon. Lord Jesus, patawarin mo kami, Panginoon. Gusto namin mapunta sa right side, Panginoon, pagdating sa huling araw. Ayaw namin mahatulan, Panginoon, hallelujah, kasama ang Diablo. I-grab namin ang opportunity, Panginoon, sa hapong ito na ikaw ay paglingkuran. Panginoon, kasama namin ang aming mga kapwa bisita. Ikaw lang ang nakakita kung ano ang takbo ng kanilang isip sa mga oras na ito. Abutin mo ang kanilang espiritu at kaluluwa. Yakapin mo sila, Panginoon, sa iyong nakalangit na presensya. Pagpalaay mo ang kanilang trabaho dito sa abroad. Isang araw maging kasapi sila, Panginoon, sa iyong katawan na iglesia. Dahil ikaw lang po ang kaligtasan at tulad na kong iba. Panginoon, ang ramdaman nila, Panginoon, na dakila mong pag-ibig. Panginoon, kami ng kasala, Panginoon, kailangan namin ang tagapagligtas. At ikaw, kami kaligtasan. I believe that everybody is really. According to 1 Corinthians, if you can look at the screen for a moment. 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 23. Paul said, "For I have received of the Lord that which also I delivered unto you, that the Lord Jesus, the same night in which He was betrayed, took bread." Verse 24. "And when He had given thanks, He said, He break it and said, 'Take, eat, this is my body, which is broken for you. This do in remembrance of me.'" There's only one requirement. When you eat this bread as a symbol of His broken body, let your mind think about the pain and the agony and the sacrifice of the Lord on the cross. As you have read the scripture. Heavenly Father, we are holding the emblem of your broken body. We are going to eat this in honor and in remembering of what you have done on the cross of Calvary for us. Shall we eat this all together in Jesus' name? Can you hold the cup in your right hand again? In verse 25. "After the same manner also He took the cup, when He had supped, saying, 'This cup is the new testament in my blood. This do ye as soon as ye drink it in remembrance of me.'" Heavenly Father, we are holding the symbol of your blood. Lord, thank you
the power of the blood that cleanses all away our sins. We are going to drink this in remembrance of you, Lord Jesus. Shall we drink it all together in Jesus' name? Can you put down the cup in a safe location? And if you feel to kneel down or come to the altar, it's up to you. And I want everybody to dedicate your life to the Lord. That whatever happens in this world, you will become a devoted follower of our Lord Jesus Christ. Tell your soul, I said, tell your soul, I am a devoted follower of Jesus Christ. I am a devoted follower of Jesus. Pray for your family, pray for your job, pray for your employer, pray for your soul. Sa aming mga bisita, pwede ko kayong makaupo. So I'm going to roam around and pray for you. Praise God. Hallelujah. Are you on the right side? How will you know that you are on the right side?